great morning, you guys. Great morning. Today is going to be an amazing day in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank God for who he is and what he's doing in our amazing life. Today I want to talk about there is always someone in need of it. There's always someone in need who needs to hear it. There is someone always who needs to hear the love of God, about the love of God, about how God saved your life. So let's go to the throne of grace, God. Guys, then we're going to get right into it. So, Father God, we come to your throne of grace right now, God. Thank you just for your grace, God. Thank you for your love right now, God. We surrender it all to you right now in the name of Jesus, God. Take everything that is not of you away from us, God. We want to be more like you, God. Allow us to rest in your presence, rest in your need, God, in the need that you want, Father God. We want to be able to desire things that you want, God. Allow us, Father God, to allow our desires to be your desires, God. We thank you for our families and friends and loved ones, God. We thank you, Lord Jesus, for our limbs this morning, being able to move, God. We thank you for our senses, God. Thank you, God, for being able to praise and worship you, God. You are the great I am, God. You are the almighty God. You are the Lord of lords. You are the King of kings, God. And we thank you, God, for your word today, God. Allow us to share your love with others, God, and how you have saved us and how you have changed us and delivered us, God. We thank you, God, right now. Just for your word, God. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for your comforter, God. Thank you for your Holy Spirit, God. Increase in us. Make us more like you, God. We thank you, Lord Jesus, for all the things that you have done in our lives and everything that you are going to do, God. Thank you for your protection, God. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for your traveling grace and your mercy, God. We thank you on today, God. Just for being who you are, God. Thank you for another opportunity, God, to get it right with you again. Thank you for a great day, it shall be in your mighty name. A great week, it shall continue to be, God. This is our prayer, your son, Jesus' name, I do pray. And it is so, amen. So, yeah, there's always someone in need who needs to hear it. Always someone who needs to hear about the love of God. So, today it talks about sharing Jesus. Give praise to the Lord. Proclaim his name. Make known among the nations what he has done. I just want to thank God for healing right now, man, over my body, over my son's body. And thank you, God, for my wife not getting a cold, God. Thank you right now, Jesus, for protecting those people and all the kids, God, in school and all the people at work, God, in the warehouses and who are working close by each other, God. Pray for your protection right now in your mighty name. Just have to get it out, guys. So, so Isaiah 12 and 4, that's where it came from. So make sure you guys read Isaiah 12, man. Proclaiming, man, his name and just talking about how good God is. So today, talked about Dwight Moody. It says, shortly after Dwight Moody, 1837 to 1999, came to faith in Christ, the evangelist, resolved not to let a day pass without sharing God's good news with at least one person. When I read that, guys, that hit me. Like, all I want to do is reach one person, man. I can reach one person a day and encourage them and not allow them to give up or to feel like they are not, to feel like they are alone. Feel like, and they need to feel that. It's always hope. Always hope. God is always on their side. And there's nothing he cannot handle, man. There's nothing he will put on you that you can't bear. So let's get back to the words. Back to this word. So on busy days, he sometimes forget his resolution until late. I'm talking about Dwight Moody. One night, he was in bed before he remembered. As he stepped outside, he thought, no one will be out in this pouring rain. Sometimes I get on here, man, I'll be like, man, nobody gonna listen. But I don't let that discourage me, you guys. I'm like, somebody need this, you know, somebody gonna come by past this maybe a year later. You feel me? As long as I can help somebody, man. It says, just then he saw a man walking down the street. When he's by the man, just think about, man, you sharing the love of God daily outside. And, you know, it's pouring down. You think nobody's going to be out. But this guy, Dwight Moody, sees somebody walking down the street. Moody rushed over and asked to stand under his umbrella to avoid the rain. Imagine asking somebody to stand up under their umbrella nowadays. So when granted permission, he asked, have you any shelter in this time of storm? Could I tell you about Jesus? Can I tell you about Jesus, man? When he was out there in the rain, man, he wasn't playing no games, man, about sharing the love of God. Man, this is so encouraging. It says Moody embodied a readiness to share how God saves us from the consequences of our sins. He obeyed God's instructions, man, to the Israelites to proclaim his name and make known among the nations what he has done. That came from Isaiah 12 and 4. Not only were God's people called to proclaim that his name is exalted, but they were also to share how he had become their salvation. Man, without God in my life, I don't know where I'd be. Sometimes I'd be like, man, I mean, you know, I'd be needing just a touch from him. Just one touch from you, Lord, will make everything all right. And he comes and he shows up, man, and shows out in my life. So just by his love and his touching and the personal relationship I have with him, I can't deny him and how he has changed my life. He says, centuries later, our call remains to tell the wonders of Jesus for becoming a man, dying on the cross, and rising again. Perhaps we heard about God's love when, as Moody did, someone left their comfort zone to talk with us about Jesus. And we too, each in our own way, can let someone know about the one who saves, which is Jesus Christ. So I thank God for saving my life, man, for allowing me to yield to him and coming to me personally and giving me that touch of love, man. It was just like never before, man. I was so, you know, I was living in the dark, man. I was living the life of a homosexual, living the homosexual lifestyle, man, doing these things, man, that I knew was not of God. I don't care how many people told me it was all right. I knew something wasn't right. So when I surrendered my life to God, man, and surrendered to and gave everything to him, I mean, I had to give everything to God. Not just some things, all things. It was that pornography. You had to give up pornography. Some of your friendships, if they were toxic. You had some past relationships or some past people that you was talking to, you're still talking to, and you was like, why I'm still talking to this person? We did this and that together. There's no use to us talking right now, especially when you get married and stuff. So I just wanted to share that with you guys, man. A lot of people, you know, will say, you know, you just have to go by your truth. What is God's truth? What is the truth of the Holy Spirit? Most people don't want to give up their truth for God and don't want to live their life, you know, based on how God wants them to live. He is our creator, man, and he is a way we have to live. He gives you the life of freedom. He gives you the life to live. You know, he gives you a choice to make, and it's up to us, man. He loves us just that much to be able to make our own choices. And most people be like, I was born this way. Yeah, you might was born with these feelings and stuff like that, but he loves you so much that he will change you. He loves you to change you, to come to him. He wants you to come to him so he can change you, so he can lead you and guide you on the path of righteousness, you guys. So I won't go on and on about that. But man, I just want to help somebody, man. And because, man, my life is a testimony. I would tell anybody that, man, God saved me. I have a wife, I have a child now, and nobody can tell me God can't do it. He's doing it through my life, and just by going through all these surgeries, like I had started these surgeries last year in June, man, and I had 5 surgeries, and God brought me out, you know, every time. And I'm like, that's something to be grateful and thankful about right there, knowing how God Almighty took me and kept me through the processes, even though I was, you know, struggling with the pain, man, when I used the bathroom, when I past a stool, it was so painful. But now I feel like the healing is starting to take place, and I thank and praise God for that, man, because there were times when I felt like giving up, man, and he came and he held me tight. And I thank God for my wife, man, my family, and the people that are checked on me, man. That's very encouraging, man. A lot of people are going through something, man, and they just need a text message from you, a call from you, man. So be that person, man, to share the gospel. And then that's why I'm not going to stop sharing my testimony and sharing how God has brought me out. God is healing me right now through all these painful surgeries and these late night and these on my knees crying out to God, I will not stop telling people about the love of Jesus, man. Like I said, if I can encourage one person today, I'm good with that, man. I'm just so excited about what God is about to do in this process, man. Even through this pandemic, God is still in the blessing business. Don't give up on God, because he won't give up on you. So let me go back to the reflection, man. I'm sorry, I had to just get up just for a minute. It says, my son was sick a couple of days. Now he's feeling so much better. And I thank God for his healing, man. I touched my son and I prayed over him. And, man, it was like something lifted up off him. The next day, he was feeling better. He got better and better. I was like, man, all it takes sometimes is us to speak that thing, man. Speak that thing into existence. You have the power to speak over the enemy, to speak against, you know, death and all that stuff, man. So be mindful of that, man. It says, what has God done in your life that you can share with others? I just shared my testimony, how God brought me out of homosexuality and stuff like that. How has he equipped you to present the good news, man, through social media? I know he's telling me, man, do more on social media, because a lot of people are watching. A lot of people, especially in our time, are on social media, and they need to hear how God changed my life. So that's what I'm doing, man. I'm doing the best I can. And I need to do more. I need to do more. I'm not gonna knock myself down, you know, and beat myself up about not what I'm doing. I'm just gonna start doing it and not talk about it. You feel me? So let's go to the throne of grace, guys. Then we're gonna close out.
Let's pray together. Thank you, Father, for drawing us to you by your Holy Spirit and setting us free from our sins, Jesus. Fill us with your love and give us the courage to tell others about our transformed lives and how they too can be set free. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. The word says you shall be transformed by the renewing of your mind. So with that being said, you guys, man, let God do the transformation. Let God do the transforming. Let the word do the transforming. So many people allow other people's words to transform their mind, and that's how they end up in the darkness and end up going the way that God don't want them to go. So that's all I want to share with you guys today. I love you all, man. God loves you more. Thank you guys for watching, man. God is so awesome. He is so real. Nobody can tell me he isn't real. He gave me a personal touch. Like, we have this personal relationship, man. God is so awesome. He's doing some marvelous things that he will continue to do. Let me tell you something. God is so mighty and so strong, man. Continue to rely on him, man, and rely on the Holy Spirit. God can do it. If God can bring me out of homosexuality, he can change my life after going through all that over the years after I was molested. He transformed my mind because I came to him, how I was going to him daily. I did not go to people, because people will lead you wrong. They want to, people will have the tendency of, you know, telling you stuff just to make you feel loved because they are your friend. But you need that friend in Jesus, you feel me? To help you transform, be transformed by the renewing of his word, you feel me? All right, and renewing of your mind by his word. All right, guys, I'm out, man. Have a fantastic day in the mighty name of Jesus, man. I'm just so excited about the good news of Jesus. God bless you all. If you need me, I got you.